Continuing the same thought, let's now talk about the whole concept of how images are focused. Here, as I have said, image is being formed at the focal plane of this lens. All light is hitting there, it's converging to a point, and I should get a nice crisp image here. What happens if I was to now try to move the image further or backwards? If I move it backwards, what should happen is multiple kind of copies should be available because none of the rays of light that are coming through the lens would converge at that point. They mostly converge. In fact, they always converge at the focal point. So you should see a little bit of a blurry image. Of course, I'm just simulating that here. Similarly, if I move the image plane in front of the focal plane, I should also get a blurry image. So focusing most of the time in a camera is done by moving the sensor or sometimes, of course, the lens forward and backwards to basically make sure that the image is formed at the focal point and the distance between the image and the sensor plane where the image is formed is set to the focal length of the lens that's been given. So the focusing concept basically is where we move the lens in relationship with the imaging plane, which should be on the focus plane. By just moving those two things together, you can now make sure that the image is formed exactly at the image plane, which is now at the focal plane. So image plane has to be at the focal plane to be able to generate a smooth, crisp image. If it's after or before the focal plane, you will see blurriness. So focusing is done by moving the sensor or the lens in relationship to each other to be able to create a relationship where the distance between the lens and the image plane is exactly aligned to where the focus plane for that lens would be. In doing so, we guarantee that the image is going to be crisp and focused on the image plane. If it's in front, that is the sensor or the image plane is in front of the focal plane or after it, that's behind it, you will get a blurry image. Let's look at another example of this. Here I'm just showing you three images. Again, for this image here, all the light is going through my lens, and of course, it's forming on the image plane or the sensor here. Of course, by changing this relationship, if I get this closer, if the object is farther away from it, you will get to see the smaller object. But in essence, what I was talking about with focusing is here, this is the best focus point here. And basically how the lens moves with respect to this is essential to be able to get a crisp image or a blurry image as are noticed here. We looked at this whole concept a little bit for pinhole cameras again, and that size, of course, the size of the pinhole was the reason for creating blurry images or not.